In this video, I'll be sharing my tips on what I find to be the best folder structures for photos, and I'm gonna tell you how to back up your photos so you won't have the painful experience of losing your files like I did. If you want to get more tips and tricks for creative photography, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video each Wednesday. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna talk about a really important topic for photographers where I have the feeling it's not really shared enough. It's about how to save and structure your files. So at the beginning of my photography, I was super lazy. I only had one hard drive, and if this one was full, I would get another one and start saving my newer images on this one. So basically what happened was that I was editing photos actually on a flea market, pretty unprofessional, I know, but there was a lot of time while selling my clothes, and I just had my computer with me, my hard drive, and I had one friend at the flea market as well, and she just accidentally tangled up in the wires of the hard drive and just ripped it to the ground. So I lost all of my photos on this hard drive, which was of course really painful. I luckily had most of the images already like edited and saved somewhere else on my computer, but all the raw files were lost. So that was actually the moment where I realized this is not how it's gonna work for the future. If I have any really important jobs and I lose them that way, that would be super embarrassing and really problematic actually. So there are two different ways of how you can save your files. And the first way how you can save your files is to have two different hard drives with the same pictures on it. So just save your images on two hard drives at the same time. One is staying at home, one is the to-go hard drive if you are on a shoot somewhere, but one is always at home. And if you are on a shoot, for example, I sometimes even take two hard drives and save them on both hard drives, but then you have to make sure that like there is another hard drive lying at home with the same pictures you already have on the hard drives, because if you crash them, like all of your images are gone, which is not good. So basically most of the time I have two hard drives. I save all of my images on both hard drives and I named them so I can actually, I know which two hard drives fit together. So these ones are called Orca and Delphin, because, you know, it's just a fun way to remember. I also have cat and dog, and you can name it whatever you would like to. You can also just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you know, 1, 2 fit together, 3, 4 fit together, etc. So yeah, that is the first way how you can save your images. That was actually the way I started to save my images after this incident. And I haven't lost any images after that ever again, which is really good. But you have to know, like, I have these lazy hard drives and they're quite expensive. Like one of them, I think they're 2 terabytes. So one of them is around, I think, 150 euros right now. So if you always have to buy two of them, it gets super pricey at some level, you know. So the second way, if you are a little bit more professional or you want to become more professional, you can invest in a server. So I went this path 2 years ago. I got the Synology DS918 Plus with 32 terabytes and it's working perfectly for me. It's always at home, so it's like my base where all my images are on. And the good thing about a server is that they are already like 2 sets of hard drives. So all of your images are actually getting saved on 2 hard drives at the same time without you moving a finger. So you just have to save your images on a server and it's automatically gonna split it and save it on 2 hard drives at the same time. So if any of the hard drives, because there are actually hard drives in the server, are gonna crash or getting damaged or whatever, it's always be secure. Like all of your files are still on 2 other hard drives and they're safe and sound. So you don't have to worry. So actually, since I have the server, I'm really like peaceful in my mind because I know where all my images are saved on and I know that they are safe. They are here at home. And if I'm on a shoot, of course, I will take like my hard drives with me and I will save the images on them, mostly on 2. And if I'm home, I'm straight gonna save them on my server and then I can clean my hard drives again so they don't like get messy with all the shoots I do. And one extra tip I have for you is to have one extra hard drive where you save all your photos, all the files you have on your server, you save on this hard drive, and then just storage it somewhere else, like bring it to your parents' house or to your sister's house or wherever you think the files are safe. And then if it eventually something happens, like in your apartment, in your house, wherever you have your server, you have like a copy of all the files still somewhere else. So this way you can be pretty safe to not lose any of your files anymore. So what is your worst experience with losing images? Let me know in the comments below and let's share some stories. So let's have a look of how I structure my images in my server and on my hard drives. So you can see now here I'm on my server and I have a folder which is called archive. I have all my images on there. I have another folder jobs where I have like the current jobs I'm doing. So I have quicker access to all my files. If I finish a job, I will move it to archive, to the year, whatever year I had this job in, probably the current year, and I have important documents. So if I go on archive, you can see I have structured it for my year. So 2014 was actually the year where I started photography, so it's already a couple of years ago. So I have a lot of photos, and if I go on any year, for example 2019, you can see I have structured all my images, all my projects with the same structure, which is the year, which is 2019 in this case, underscore, then the month where I shot these images in, underscore, and then a name for whatever project it was or something I associated with it. So I know when I'm reading here all the titles, I actually know what images are in this file. And if I have like a bigger job, I have also files in there. So you can see I have a couple of different folders in here, for example, my final images, and I've divided it into the web size of the images and the print size of the images. I have my PSD files here as well. I have my layout, if I have any kind of layout. I have like the first round of how I edited them, and then of course my raw files, and the raw files are also like separated in different folders so I know which set it was on. So this is actually how I structure all of my images, and I always use an underscore to divide, for example, the year, the month, and the name, because most computer systems can actually find images or folders better if you use an underscore instead of any kind of other character you want to use, for example a blank space or something like this. So always use an underscore, because maybe sometime in the future you are accessing your images from another computer, not MacBook or anything else, and it's always easier for the computer to find your images if you want to search them. So this is how I make sure to keep an overview of all my photos and to structure them the right way so I can find them really easily again. I hope this was really helpful for you and you can adapt some of my tips for your own structure and your own saving procedure for your photos. If you want to get more photo inspiration, you can definitely check out my Instagram account. I always post my newest photos on there and also really interesting behind the scenes videos. If you want to learn about the mistakes I did as a beginner photographer that you definitely should avoid, you can check out this video. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you next Wednesday.